Uganda exports over 16 metric tons of tea, which contributes a reasonable percentage to the country's gross domestic product, as confirmed by Rajiv Kamali and Mohammed Mustafa from Rwenzori Commodities, who are key players in the tea sector.
Every Ugandan, you know, is being supported by tea sector, directly or indirectly, you can say so. It is not only tea, you know, many people or many families depend on teas. If you are buying tea, you need machinery, you need raw material, you need logistics. So, you know, many people are indirectly also involved in tea sector. So everybody, they have to support, and they have been supporting.
It is very affordable. It's one of the most affordable commodities there is out there. Actually, tea would be the biggest commodity you'd find in a household. Any Ugandan household, there's definitely a tea brand in there.
However, the industry is being threatened by the effects of COVID-19. Industrial players have now appealed to the government for intervention.
We have been suffering a tea, you know, sector affected badly due to economic crisis in the whole world, you know, the fluctuation in dollar and other currencies. And mostly all Uganda teas, okay, goes to Mombasa for auction. And in auction are costing maybe around 1.7 approximately. But what we get it is around 1.2, 1.3.
While Uganda joined the rest of the world to commemorate International Tea Day in Kampala, experts emphasize the health benefits of drinking tea, most especially boosting the immunity.
Apart from other emotional and relational concepts, it's having lots of health benefit also. ISBAT is one of the leading educational institutions in Uganda. Being an educational institution, it is one of our ethical responsibility also to take care about the good health of the citizen. Tea is having so many ingredients which are actually good to reduce the diabetes, even the chances of stroke, stress, and it also boosts up the aging, slow down the process of aging.
The industry also plays a major role in fighting unemployment, especially among youth.
Employment opportunities, like he said, from the ground up, the root of the tree, the beginning of the process, there are a lot of opportunities there. From then on, we go to the factory. The factory has machinery, it requires people to operate said machinery. That requires people, jobs, and employment.
The International Tea Day is marked on the 21st of May every year. However, the celebrations were delayed, postponed until today. Report by Ismail Nsubuga for the news.